I'll take the service exit, thanks. Go with that one. I don't think I've gone this far. Thank you. Ground floor.
At last, the willful prince has ventured all the way up to the surface of the mortal realm. Yet still he is encased within the earth itself. The gateway to the underworld. A threshold from which there is no escape.
We'll see about that. Some of those urns have coin in them, don't they? No, not this.
The multi-headed Cerberus stands vigilant before the underworld's entryway. The tales of what happens to those foolish enough to attempt to pass are far too graphic to describe.
So it's really come to this, boy. After everything we've been through. Well then, this is how it has to be. There's nothing left to say. Except for, on your guard. No, but seriously, boy. I know why you're here. There has to be a way to make you look the other way. What if I help you with the Satyr problem? Would you let me go? Please. I have to find Persephone. My mother. You know what this means to me.
After a moment's hesitation and deliberation, the voracious Hound of Hell barks once affirmatively toward the prince, who sets off in search of something that can sate the monster's appetites.
Good. Now I just need to head off the beaten path here and see what I can find. This one, I guess. Hey! Poisoned at the moment, thanks. Gimme. appreciate the backup. Hope this can get me out of here. Got to keep searching. Should stock up for the road ahead. Cheers, mate. All these tunnels. Maybe this way. Data storage.
As you can see by now, we are a big and clever family, little Hades. My niece Athena here being the cleverest of all. You'd never know that she was childless the way she looks after and cares for all of us.
Surely my cleverness comes from your brother and yourself, Lord Uncle Poseidon. And I would only add, my feeling is we've more than enough children in this family. Thus, no further need for more of them for now.
Two for one. Disgusting. Cerberus will love it. Not now.
Much better.
Down the chute. Oh, Cerberus. Should check this way. Crawlers. hungry, huh? Snake stone is that? All right, boy, I got your favorite treat. But you have to promise to let me pass if I hand it over, okay?
Terrifying Cerberus accepts the fetid sack and scans the darkened hall for where best to consume the stomach-turning contents.
I owe you one, boy. I did it.
I never grew accustomed to the air up here. It gusts senselessly whichever way it pleases. I suppose you must prefer it to the stillness of the air below.
You know, you're right. The air up here seems pretty good so far. But I will reserve judgment till I've had my fill. I have to say, though, Father, the Helm of Darkness suits you. I'm touched you dust it off on my account.
It should not have had to come to this. For all your antics with me yet around the house, I always kept my temper, have I not? Unlike you.
Well, let's see. You've berated me repeatedly and often. You've lied to me, mustered your wretched forces to kill me over and over, but sure, I'll grant you that you've always kept most of your anger bottled up. All that's about to change, then?
We're gods, boy. Killing one another is our lot. Although I always thought I was above it. I told you that you cannot leave this place. It seems I must enforce my rules myself. I'm sending you home. Now.
No, you're going home, not me.
Oh. I suppose that you must hate the very sight of me. You'll understand then why I wear the Helm of Darkness. Excuse me for a moment. Against me like this, boy.
What do you think, Father?
I think that you are an ignoble rat.
But you think better of me, sir.
Darkness. Last for long. You mind your manners once you return to my hall.
Damn you, Father.